and welcome to another exciting episode of Off the Pitch. My name is Brenda Shima, your regular host on your favorite sports entertainment program. Right here, we'll be talking to a Nigerian football player who'll be telling us all about his life on and off the pitch. But like the show's name says, it is Off the Pitch. We'll be getting right into all of that right after the short break. So guys, don't go anywhere. Sit back and relax. The show can start in just a moment.
Hello, I'm Cyril Kola with the Desers, the forward for the Super Eagles.
I'm Jaribo, Rangers midfielder, Super Eagles midfielder.
My name is Godin Silvio, an attacker for Casapia in Portugal.
Hi guys, my name is Victor Sime, Napoli and Super Eagles striker.
Keep watching OTP with Brenda.
Keep watching OTP with Brenda.
Keep watching OTP with Brenda.
Keep watching OTP with Brenda. God bless.
Welcome back from that short break. If you just joined us, once again, the show is Off the Pitch and I am your host, Brenda Shima. Right here on this show, we get to talk to some Nigerian football players to know what is going on with them outside football. And like I said earlier, our guest is waiting. And of course, he's got so much to tell us about his personal life. So guys, let's get right into it. So, TEMITOPE, it's good to have you on this episode of Off the Pitch. Thanks for joining us here today.
Thank you very much.
All right, so quickly, this is the show where you get to find out from Nigerian players like yourself what it is about them that we don't know on screens. So let's hear from you, the host himself. Who is TEMITOPE? What's TEMITOPE all about? Where are you from? Where were you born? Your family background? And then give us a little bit and bit about your history also.
Thank you very much. Like you said, my name is Olusesi TEMITOPE Emmanuel. Originated from Ondo State, precisely Oselokan government. But I was born and brought up in Delta State, Saple precisely.
Wari?
Saple.
Okay.
So that's where my parents live. Most of the time, when I'm on break, that's where I do live. It has been a really tough journey for me as a footballer. I would say it's all about God. First of all, we say God, I give glory to God, because without Him, with your hard work, with that determination, I don't think you can come outside victorious. But when God is there, things can look like it's coming your way perfectly. Like I said, I was born and brought up in Delta State, Saple.
So you know how to speak pidgin. So I speak pidgin. Yeah,
yeah. Now my shoppings.
Yeah. So worry. You don't have to say worry. Worry streets now.
Those ones. So, like I said, I started from there. My grassroots football.
That's Delta Force.
No, I didn't play Delta Force. I really played Saple Football Academy there. I was not opportune to play for Delta Force. And there was a team there in Saple that play as a pro team in the league, Upper United. I did all I can to make sure that I played them, because then I was not a professional footballer yet. I was still
moving
around. So I was trying my best to meet up with that level, but unfortunately I could not. It's not just because I can't play them, but it was just that I was too small. I was just a small boy, but I have a very big heart because I want to play. So I didn't have that opportunity, so I have to leave home. We are five in the family, and two boys and three girls. And I'm the first son of the house and the second born. And I knew what it means to be the first son, so I was so hungry to go out and become a man in the early stage. I had the opportunity to go higher in my educational career, but unfortunately, my love for the football and based on financial issues, which my parents were having then, because they promised me that they're going to take me to anywhere I want to go.
In terms of school. Or circumstances.
Yeah, circumstances plainly. So I was even in a better position. I was happy seeing myself not going to school, going back to the football, because that's what I love doing.
So you prayed for circumstances now?
I did, because my dad was so strict and most of the time warned me, please don't go to the field. I don't want to see the field. Go to school. I will take you to anywhere you want to go. I would say, okay, no problem. But maybe in the morning when you go out for work, before you come back,
I play.
Before you come back, I take my bath, refresh myself. I'll be waiting for him. So okay, good. He didn't go to school because I said no, I didn't go to school. There was a day I went to school and I got injured playing at school. So I came back home. I have to go to bed early. I'm the type that I don't go to bed early. You won't see me sleeping earlier. So I came back home. I started sleeping. My mom saw me.
What's wrong young with man, you?
This can't be you. You can't be sleeping by this time. It's not you. She stood far from me. I said, hey, boy, come. Let me see. Yeah, okay, you don't have to play football again. Very good. Don't worry. Me, myself, I will break your leg. You stop to play the football.
Right.
So I was just crying. But my mom was there for me. She pushed me to go for what I love doing. She encouraged me. And thank God for everything.
All right.
Things happened very good. I signed my first contract as a professional footballer with the Atlanta.
Relegated Atlanta now.
Then it was a very good and a great club.
All right, so that was quite an introductory message, and I must say you have a whole lot of story right there. Definitely. That has been untold, and I'm happy that you're saying it right here on the show. We really do appreciate that.
All right,
so moving away from all of that story you had growing up, I'm having to this point, let's talk about your professional football. You said you started with Heartland of Owerri. And after that, where was your next step? And then coming right into the Super Eagles Team B, how did you take that leap of message? I mean, let's start from that. How did you take the message of your call up into the Super Eagles Team?
Yeah, I would say for me, this is not the first call up for me. I was among the home base player that went for the game against Mexico in US.
And when we failed 4-0,
for me we didn't
fail. It was an experience.
It was a great experience, and with the crops of players, then we have much time to prepare for the game, but we still go there and we represent the country. I would say we represent the country very well, because it was a very difficult game. I would say it's a very great privilege for me. It's not that I'm the best, but I would say that I'm blessed and I'm favored by God Almighty. It's a great opportunity, because right now I'm the captain of the home base.
This is the player who gave a round of applause for the captain. Skipo.
I'm the captain, and also the captain of my club, Enugu Rangers.
That's
so
good.
I know what it means to lead a team, and I know what it means to have players around you and trying to
carry everybody along, achieve
your target. I would say it's a great privilege. Most people ask me if this tax is not much for me. I would say it's not, for me it's not a tax, it's a chance for me to prove myself and to tell the world, the country, that
this is what I'm made of.
Yeah, it's a captain. This guy is born to be a captain, he's born to lead. And I would say it's a big privilege for me.
All right, let's get up personal a little bit, Skipo. I'll start calling you Skipo. Let's get personal a little bit, Skipo. You talk about family, but I didn't hear you say about children, wife, and relationship. So tell us about that, Skipo. Are you in a relationship? Are we supposed to have like a female Skipo coming along soon? Or is there already someone right there?
Yeah, I would say for now, right now, I'm not, I'm in a relationship, but I'm not.
You're not married.
I'm not married yet. I don't have kids yet, but I'm trying to see that all those things come true within a short period of time. I know within a short period of time it will manifest, but it's just about time. You just have to calculate yourself for things
properly. So you're planning and preparing and getting ready.
Yeah.
All right. Definitely. So we'll look out for that. We'll try to follow you along. Also, if you never get to play football someday, aside from playing football as it is now, what other career will you pick up and do? What other thing would you do aside from, if you were not a footballer, what would you be doing?
That's a funny question.
No, but that's straightforward. Like, if you're not a footballer, what would you be doing? Or it'd still be football?
No, I would say initially before getting into football, I had dreams of becoming a medical doctor. Because then I love medicine. Even in my days of school, I try to cope up. But you know, being a medical student, you need to have a lot of focus and concentration.
Yes, and that's how football is. You have to have a lot of focus to excel.
Yeah, there's no way you can focus on medicine and focus on football.
Because most of the time,
football takes every of your time.
Physical strength and mental strength.
So I have to leave one for one. That's why I choose the football. But I like the medicine, be a doctor. That will be my, if not football, that would be my.
That's quite, you still be saving lives or maybe not breaking hearts. Let me put it out, because footballers are known to break hearts. So you be saving lives and not breaking hearts.
No,
I was just JK.
Yeah, I know. but on a other aspect, that's what everybody thinks footballers are. They don't stick to one partner, they go around. But most of the times, not every one of the footballers.
I was actually talking about the game. Because it's very good, I've actually broken our hearts a couple of times.
Yeah.
But yeah, now that you've said that, you're right. Yeah. So yeah, it's been an amazing time talking to you so far. But again, like, I would like to know, you're a Nigerian, you're from the western part of Nigeria.
Yeah.
And then let's know, what is your favorite Nigerian delicacy? What is that one thing you must eat in a week or in a day, if possible? Let me not say a day, because you might be in different places, but in a week, you must have that meal. What is that one food that you like about delicacy about Nigeria?
For me, I'm type of person, most of the times, I'm
difficult to
predict. I just take what I feel like having at that particular time. Most of the times, I might just live for a week without even taking swallow, eating rice, eating beans, plantain. But on a normal day, like in a week, I can stick to rice, beans, plantain for a week.
That's a good thing. Future wife, be aware, you're going to have a good time. No stress, anything goes. Right?
It doesn't mean that I don't like to swallow. There are some of them I like, and I like it.
All right, that was quite an information right there. But thank you so much for your time. So
we're
about to head
much.
To the next segment of the show, which is the final segment, the game segment. Oh. Right here, we have it in two parts. We have the penalties and the free kick. For the penalties, questions around the Super Eagles and the free kicks, general knowledge question, which you should know as a human being, as a Nigerian.
Okay.
So you're going to have an option to pick either two penalties and one free kick, or two free kick and one penalties. But we'll have three questions to be answered. So which one would it be for you?
Obviously, I'll pick two penalty and one free kick.
You pick two penalties?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, let's go with penalties. We've got two penalties and one free kick right here for Tope. So, Tope, first penalty question.
Okay.
Super Eagles made their FIFA debut for the World Cup in what year?
What?
You picked penalties. I mean, you should be confident about things of the Super Eagles.
Wow.
You have 5 seconds to answer that.
That I can't remember.
All right, so let me just help you out. You have 3 more seconds left. 1992, 1994, and 1996. What year was their debut for the FIFA World Cup?
I would think I would go for 1994.
All right, so that was an S4. You got it right.
1994.
All right, so okay, how many appearances? The next question. How many appearances have the Super Eagles made in the FIFA World Cup so far? This is quite recent, so you should know this one.
Recent.
You should. How many appearances? We were about making our next appearance, but somehow we got cut out of it. So how many appearances have we made in the FIFA World Cup so far? You're flying a green, white, green jersey. You should know this.
I would like you to give me the option.
Okay,
maybe I get a clue from there.
All right, so I give you option one, option A, two, option B, four, option C, six.
I'm good for B, four.
Is that your final answer? All right, so that's his final answer, because I give you a lot of breaks. B is the wrong answer. They actually had 6 appearances so far.
Oh.
We're about going for our 7th when Ghana cut us out. right here, and the MCO Abiola Stadium in Abuja. So that's why I said it was recent. You shouldn't forget that one.
Oh.
All right, very so that's one down. My penalty is waiting for me. So the next question is your free kick, right? Are you ready to go for the free kick? I hope you get this one too.
Let's go.
All right, so spell hippopotamus.
Wow. Wow, wow. Okay.
Okay, hippopotamus.
H-I.
Uh-huh.
Double P.
All right.
O-T. O-T-M-U.
Hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus, H-I. P-P. O-T.
You have three more seconds.
A-M-O-U-S.
All right, you almost got it, but it's H-I-P-P-O-T-A-M-U-S. Hippopotamus.
M-U-S.
But you didn't call the other P, you just said P-P-O-T-O. That free kick wasn't really a free kick. You didn't even take it that well.
Hippopotamus. H-I-P-P.
Mm-hmm. O-P.
Oh,
O-P.
Sorry. Sorry.
All right, so that was a good one. That was 2-3. So you're going to do me a penalty. Either you sing or you do a press up for me.
Sing, I'm not a good singer.
All right. So what are you going to do, press up for me or frog jump?
No, that's difficult. We have gotten enough this morning, so doing that is overload.
All right, so let me just pardon you for this one. But next time, you should get know a lot about the spread, because yeah, that's the team you're playing.
Yeah,
so
definitely.
Just quickly, your parting words to family, friends, loved ones, well wishers, and all of that.
Without your support and your prayers, it's going to be difficult for us. So we want you guys to continue praying for us. Keep showing your love and keep supporting the Super Eagles. And I pray God bless you and keep all of you. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you so much for your time, Tope. And wish you all the best. And we'll be looking out for you guys, all of you.
Good brother. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you. Have a great one.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah, bye.
No more kingdom. Oh, no more kingdom. Oh, no more kingdom waiting for you.
Well, quite an interesting package we had today indeed. Well, on that note, we draw the curtains on this episode of the show. But again, it's coming your way same time, same station next week. And for now, for all your comments and contributions, simply send us a message on any of our social media platforms showing right now on your TV screen. And also for sponsorship, the details are right there in front of you. So hit us up, guys. Let's know what you think about this show. My name is Brenda Shima saying, see you again, same time, same station next week. Bye for now.